Is it normal that my father still hits me even as an adult? Disclaimer, this is not my story time. Send me on Instagram. When I was a kid and I got in trouble, my dad would hit me. I always knew to expect it, so it wasn't a really big deal. But of course, I would do my best to stay out of trouble. Sometimes he would use a belt, and sometimes he would slap me across the face. The slapping was the worst part. From the ages of 10 to 12, I didn't really get hit because I never got in trouble. When I turned 14, things started getting rough. I wanted to date boys, and my dad was not having it. So his form of punishment sometimes was even taking food away from me. This happened on two occasions when I was 14 and I almost ran away because of it. I know most of you are thinking that my mom should have stepped in, but my mom was pretty afraid of my dad too. Sometimes I feel like my parents have brainwashed me into thinking that what my dad is doing is fine. The sad part is that I'm now 20 and my dad still hits me from time to time. I do have to say my father has always been there for me. He's provided me with a great life and a good education. And it's not like he would just hit me out of nowhere. It was only when I got in trouble and for specific reasons. But I do think he needs to stop it because I'm 20 now. Here's where things get really messy. I just got engaged and my fiance hates my father. Follow for part two. Is it normal that my father still hits me as an adult? Now that I'm 20 and engaged, I told my fiance about what my father did. Like I said, my father wouldn't just hit me out of nowhere. He would only do it when he was punishing me and for specific reasons. But my fiance loathes my father. He thinks it's abuse and that it wasn't a normal thing for me to have to endure as a child, especially as an adult. And I've only come to realize that what my dad is doing is probably wrong because of my fiance. Before that, I never had anybody in my life tell me that what my dad was doing was wrong. But here's what happened. My fiance and I were cooking in my parents' kitchen. My dad must have been in a really bad mood because he comes into the kitchen and says, "If you don't clean up this mess, I'm gonna show your fiance how I slapped the shit out of you." My father had never shown that side of him in front of my fiance. But as soon as those words came out of my father's mouth, my fiance turned to him and said, "You will never put your hands on her again." And my dad said, "That's my daughter and I can do whatever I want." My fiance asked me to leave with him and I did. My mom called us and begged us to come back, but my fiance said no. Part three is it normal that my father still hits me as an adult? After my fiance stood up to my dad, we didn't speak to my family for about 2 months. That's when my fiance asked me to go to therapy. And I did. That's when I found out that what I really needed to do was fix my relationship with my father. Because he had always punished me physically, I held a lot of resentment towards him. And my father being very antiquated, he thought that he was doing the right thing. Now let me clear a few things up. He only hit me twice when I was an adult. Once when I was 19, I got a bad grade in one of my classes and he flipped out. He slapped me across the face and told me that that would teach me to do better. The second time was right after my 20th birthday. I had gotten into an argument with my mom that really wasn't such a big deal. My mom and I worked things out, but my dad thought it was inappropriate that I spoke to my mom like that. Was I very disrespectful? No. But to him, it was completely unacceptable. So he hit me once with his belt. My fiance is refusing to invite my parents to our wedding. And to be honest, I kind of agree with him. Ever since stepping away from my parents, I have so much more confidence. I'm also happier in my relationship because I'm getting to be myself. And I'm not afraid that anyone will punish me. But I do feel guilty. I want to reach out to my parents. I'm not sure. What should I do?
Story time about how I got a facelift when I was 18 to become a famous Instagram model. And I am a famous Instagram model. Can you guess who I am? Disclaimer, this is not my story time. This is not my story time. It was sent to me on Instagram. I grew up in the Kylie Jenner era when she started getting her lips done. Remember that? Kardashians were a Bible to me. I watched Keeping Up with the Kardashians and was totally obsessed with their looks. You see, at the time, I wasn't the prettiest girl. I was really skinny. I had no bum and no boobalas. Once Kylie Jenner started getting her body done, that's when I really started getting FOMO. To be honest, and I know this sounds cliche, but social media made me start hating my face. I would constantly compare myself to Instagram models. That's when I started photoshopping my pictures. It made me feel so much better to post. Then I begged my parents for lip fillers. They finally said yes and I went ahead and got them. For me, the next logical thing was to look like Kylie Jenner. So I decided my parents to let me get surgery. They finally said yes, but trust me, it took a long time to convince them. We went to a plastic surgeon. And that's when I decided to get a full facelift. I know it sounds severe, but it was so worth it. But I didn't stop just at my face. I even convinced my parents to get my boobalas and my bum done. Part two is, after getting all my plastic surgery at 18, I finally became a famous Instagram model. Disclaimer, this is not my story time. This is not my story time. It was sent to me on Instagram. The healing process, of course, was painful, but it was so worth it to me. Once I saw my body and my face, I felt so much better about myself. But something else was missing. Everyone on Instagram was getting their brows tattooed and lash extensions. But I went ahead and got those things done too. And I started paying back my parents for all the surgeries. So this was my basic beauty routine. I would get a mani-pedi every 2 weeks. I would get my hair colored every single month. I was getting lip fillers every 6 months. Facials every 2 weeks. Personal trainer who I exercise with 5 times a week. And I forgot to mention, I had 100,000 followers on Instagram at this point. So I was getting a lot of brand deals aside from the modeling. That's when I started noticing that Kylie Jenner's butt was looking bigger, so I wanted to get mine bigger. I also wanted to get my hips wider like her too. I even started buying all the designer stuff that Kylie was wearing too. Part 3 is up. I asked my plastic surgeon to make my butt look bigger like Kylie's.
is. Disclaimer, this is not my story time. It was sent to me on Instagram. By the way, at this point, I'd already had a full facelift and lots of body work done by the time I was 18. My plastic surgeon told me he wouldn't give me another round of butt filler. I was really, really upset. Then my parents asked me to come over. When I got to their house, they told me the plastic surgeon had called their house and told them that I was looking for more surgery. My parents were beginning to worry, but I assured them that everything was okay. I was not addicted to plastic surgery or anything like that. I just knew how competitive the modeling industry was. Instead, I decided to get filler in my face. I got my nose and my cheeks done. And that's when I started getting hired by more makeup companies. After a year, my Instagram following went from 100,000 to 1,000,000. I've modeled for over 50 brands and I'm currently planning my own brand. My Instagram followers are constantly accusing me of getting plastic surgery, but I've never admitted to anything. I'll come back to the comments and see if anybody guessed who I am. No, people hate Instagram models because they never admit to it, but I will never admit to my plastic surgery. I mean, I'll probably have plastic surgery again. Have you guessed who I am? My influencer wife is a total fraud and lies about her body being natural. I will not say who my wife is, but you go ahead and guess. My wife blew up on Instagram back in 2015. Back then, she talked about health and how our bodies were temples. But a year after she blew up, she decided to get surgery. She told me that it was going to help her grow quicker on Instagram, which it actually did. She actually stopped posting on Instagram for the 3 months that she was recovering from her surgery. During that time, she only posted recipe videos, so nobody could see her face or her body. After the 3 months, she came back to Instagram and said that she went on a 3-month detox and cleanse, that her cleanse and detox finally gave her the body she always dreamt of. But not one of her followers questioned her for having this perfect body all of the sudden. This is when she started selling her cleanse and detox book. She sold it for $150 and people ate it up. Within the first month, we made over 40 grand. And surprisingly, her followers were actually seeing changes, of course, because they were doing all the work that she didn't do. I'm pretty sure she copy and pasted recipes from the internet for the book. Around this time, she also started posting her workout videos. She would talk on Instagram about how she would go to the gym almost 5 times a week. But in reality, she would only go to the gym once or twice a week. And she'd make me come to the gym with her to get content. So I'd be following her around the gym taking videos and pictures of her. Don't get me wrong, I definitely benefit from this. Basically her cameraman and her editor. And I don't have to have a job. She also got a second surgery before launching her workout program. I was really against this because I didn't want her to get skinnier, but she went ahead and did it anyway. This time she was posting older pictures of her. But after 2 months, she came back to Instagram with the new body. That's when she dropped her new workout plan and people went crazy. Just in the first day, 500 people bought it for $150. You do the math. But here's the thing. She's talking about getting a new surgery to launch her new cleanse and her new workout book. She also wants to get stuff done to her face. She's turning 28 this year and she thinks that she's getting old. I don't want her to change her face or her body anymore. She's not the woman I married. She also thinks she's a celebrity because she gets recognized on the street, which really doesn't help. Family and I are even considering doing an intervention, but I don't think she's gonna care. She makes so much money off Instagram and people love her because of the way she looks. The more she posts, the more validation she gets, and the more money she makes. She used to hate the Kardashians, but now she worships them. She's looking more like Kim every single day. How do I tell her to stop? What should I do?